It's now been 25 years since Jesse the Body Ventura took office as Minnesota's governor. His election shocked the political world, and now a new documentary sheds new light on the professional wrestler turned politician and the impact he made in our state. Lira Goose explains.
At the time Jesse the Body Ventura took office as Minnesota governor in January 1999, Mary Lahammer was the youngest member of the Capitol Press Corps at age 24.
I had endless energy and enthusiasm and optimism, so I got along with him, figured it out, and keeping it to policy, working for PBS. We didn't necessarily cover the latest controversy, because there was always controversy, but we kind of geeked out and nerded out on the policy, and he came to really respect that, and I guess ultimately granted me more interviews than any reporter in America, he says.
I walk and talk where I want.
With insight from those countless interviews, Lahammer and other colleagues have put together a documentary called Jesse Ventura Shocks the World, premiering Tuesday night on TPT.
Every single person who's seen it, even those of us who are political reporters who lived through it, said they learned something.
The film covers Jesse's life and colorful history from birth through his career as professional wrestler and actor and ascent into politics. Lahammer says there are a lot of revelations in the film as well, including Ventura's influence on former President Donald Trump.
And what we reveal in the documentary is that Trump studied Ventura's playbook. And very much use some of the same techniques to get elected.
While others like Trump have made similar atypical journeys to elected office, in the late 90s, Ventura's election did shock the political world.
That's kind of the thesis of the film. We have a quote from him at the very beginning saying, I'm Jesse Ventura, I'm ahead of my time.
Lahammer says Ventura and his family still live in Minnesota for part of the year. His son Tyrell attended the premiere screening held last week by the MSP Film Society. Randy.
All right, Lou, thank you very much. Speaking